OTEP community, welcome back to First Frequency of Oneness, Shock Metaphysics. I am your illustrious host, Rev Shock, the metaphysical Morpheus, a.k.a. Shook Shock, a.k.a. Shook Shocker, a.k.a. Uncle Phil Philosophy, a.k.a. Shockimus Prime, and of course, my favorite of all time, Shockalicious, because I used to be a stripper and I had a stripper pole incident, and as a result, I no longer strip again. If you believe that, I do have some property in Alaska to sell you. Back with us again is our greatest physicist in the whole wide world, Mr. Ron Spears, and he should be Reverend Doctor, but that's okay. I'm gonna call him Reverend Doctor. What's going on, Doc?
Rev Shock, it's always always good to be with you, always good to be with the family, and I appreciate that high praise, my brother.
Absolutely, man. You have changed some people's lives in the last couple of months that we launched your webinar. Oh my God, your webinar changed me. It changed lives. I see, shout out to Baba Bay out there. I see you out there. He says, yes, keep me in the loop. Baba Bay, we got you in the loop, brother. We got you. Evolving Thoughts is with us. Kevin Lyles just tuned in. We've got more coming in. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So my beloved, how has the whirlwind been around the previous webinar?
Yeah, I mean, you know, just connecting with the family on that deeper level, the research of putting together the deep dive. I mean, you know, of course, you know, I'm gagged all day, but then it just went to another level. It went to a deeper level. I'm already thinking about the next level of God, which is the you know, bringing in the Dogon and a lot of that aspect into the quantum realm. So it's just going to get deeper. I mean, you know, the next webinar series is going to be, but you know, we got so deep into that Gagu, it just brought out a whole different side. So you know, that was exciting itself. And then,
yes, it is.
And I got to tell you though, when we got into that black love though, man, I mean,
they love that. They love that. All ages. That was wonderful.
Yeah.
That was great to see.
We had all ages, and the feedback was just so wonderful. The vibe and the energy was wonderful. So I'm still sort of riding high off of that.
No doubt, and
it just gives me that validation that, you know, yes, I found my gift, and there's nothing. The only thing that's greater than finding your gift is seeing people respond when you share it.
I agree. I concur. 100%.
That's kind of the best way to describe what these past couple weeks have been, and I really thank the family for that love. And thank you for, you know, a lot of the black matter lives came from the metaphysicists and the physicists as above, so below. I think show two is when I dropped the word, or I don't know if it was show one or show two when I dropped the word black matter lives.
You know? I think it was probably number two, but it was definitely early on, and you kept rocking it and rocking it. I said, dude, I think this is your book. I think that you need to loosen it. You need to write a little bit more about this. Go a little deeper. Sure enough, you did.
Yeah. So
what's up, Brian Beno? I see you coming in. What's going on, my brother from another mother? Hotep, Uncle Jobson, Ned, Uncle What's the Jet, my man. What's going on? So you have been producing something that we really desperately need, something I have thought about myself. I have a file called the 100-year process or plan, but you have done one as well. You're going to be presenting that today, and what you call, what is it, weapons of what destruction? What is it?
Weapons of mass disruption.
I love that.
Weapons
I love that
disruption.
Oh, I hate it. I hate it when you do that. I hate it when you do that. Oh, that's so good. I hate it because I wish I had a thought about it, right? You know, that was just genius, man. I love this shit.
Well, so, you know, that's black matter lives.
Love, no question. No question.
The vibration to disrupt the epigenetic signal.
Say it again. That's what I'm saying.
Love
yes, indeed.
Increases the vibration to disrupt the epigenetic signal.
Yes, yes.
Bye-bye second frequency.
Yeah. Yeah. If you love your second frequency, you don't want none of this smoke over here. You need to go somewhere else for that. Give us a bit of an outline of what you learned, what were the takeaways from the previous webinar. Deborah Bonner, how are you, my goddess? Welcome. Yes, you. The title caught your attention, absolutely, as it should. But talk to us a little bit about the webinar and how does it connect with the content that you're going to be sharing today?
Sure. Well, you know, the main thing that this is all about, and the webinar has really helped me to just sort of validate, you know, how you have a feeling about something. I've already loved the book. I mean, the book is the book, but when the webinar brings the book to life, you know what I mean? Because it's one thing to put together a great book, you want people to read it and you want people to support it, but you have to put it into action. You go from great words into action. So unity and manifestation are the main outcomes. You have to have outcomes. Otherwise, it's just a book. Just a book. If the book does not move to action and the action doesn't move to outcomes, it's just a book. And Black Matter Lives is so much more than a book. It is a movement. It is a manifestation of change. And so it's not just about the book, because the webinar focuses on all of the weapons of mass disruption. It focuses on the audiobook version of the spoken word, the curriculum for young people, rites of passage. It focuses on the Sankofa journey, okay, and the laws of physics and going back to move forward. Mm-hmm. And it focuses on Black love and the male-female energy. And so it covers all the bases. And today's presentation, I'm going to connect those dots at how this webinar and everything that comes with it will help us get to where we need to go. As Kaba says, you know, the whole concept of a 100-year plan, you know, came from Baba Kaba, you know, I listened to a recent lecture from Baba Kaba, and I said, 100-year plan. Okay, yes, Black Matter lived 100 years. What can we expect? That is something that we are that I'm going to basically drop today and say, how exactly, what all do you get with this webinar and how do you use it to effect change? And so unless you just want to sit here and watch YouTube videos and read books, no, you got to be out there manifesting. We got to have, because I see the comment about Buffalo. More is coming.
Yeah, it is. I was just, it's funny that you mentioned that, and the person who's in the chat that says rest in peace to the victims in Buffalo, Ashe O. I had a long conversation with Reverend Dr. Ray Higgins, who's coming back to the platform. He just got certified in being able to teach people firearms. So he's going to come back, and we're going to talk about how do we protect ourselves. You know, there's an aspect of where we got to bring back some of that Black Panther mentality as it relates to protecting ourselves, our women, and our children. And so Dr. Higgins is going to come back to the program and give us a in-depth understanding of that. Because I told him, I said, you know, there's really nobody better to talk about that issue than you, because he's a Marine, so he's former military, he's former law enforcement. He was a chaplain in Ohio for 20-some-odd years, police chaplain. Then he's a psychologist, he's a doctor, then he's a minister, and now he's a firearms teacher. So there's five aspects that we need to have. And so part of that is our weapons of mass. How do you refer to it? Disruption?
Disruption, disrupting the epigenetic signal.
I love it. Went off on a tangent there because I was so excited. I was also with Dr. Edwin Nichols this morning. We did a pre-recording that we're going to be doing, coming back, teaching the really deep lessons of dichotomous logic and axiology and the philosophical aspects of cultural differences. So family, we're pulling together the most brilliant minds in the world to be able to give a narration of not just, as we say, nothing's wrong with us, something happened to us. What is what has happened to us is still happening. But then the next question logically is, what the hell do we do about it? Here it is, Brother Ron Spears leading this charge and giving us actual tangible what we need to do to move forward and put it into a 100-year plan. Now, here's the PowerPoint presentation that you have. I don't know if you're ready to do it or not.
No,
I'll put us on the side for a minute. But if you want to get started, you can. Unity and manifestation.
Yeah, absolutely. Because, I mean, you know, you kind of have to start, as they say, begin with the end in mind. I mean, you got to have a plan. You got to have the outcomes. Unity and manifestation is what Black Matter Lives is all about. I mean, you know, the other thing that I really loved about the webinar is the people that were on it. Okay, you had the young and you had the elderly.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you had the former Nation of Islam, now Sunni, and we had the Baba Bay with it, which is more science temple.
Matter your heritage, family. This is what we need to have as a one. This is B1. This is first frequency and what it looks like. Absolutely.
And so that's love the that. Unity, all of the different things. It does not matter. Ma'at is ma'at. Ma'at is and it's love. Again,
Matter
lives. The first word is L, love. Love. Okay, so that's the whole unity starts with love, right? Mm-hmm. And then increasing the vibration to disrupt the epigenetic signal. And that's where we have to focus on manifestation. Starts with unity. And then as you're able to elevate your consciousness and apply what I'm teaching, then you're going to see manifestation. So that's kind of what today's lecture is going to be about. The webinar focused on Gagut. Okay, but then when we talk about manifestation, it's that Sankofa experience. Okay, and so you're going to get the documentary on Sankofa, on how I got into this knowledge and how I'm able to manifest it through the power of the spoken word. Okay, so we talked about Gagut, and that was powerful to break down the quantum physics behind the God Almighty Grand Unified Theorem. And so the manifestation comes in the form of the Sankofa experience. It comes in the form of the African rites of passage curriculum that breaks down. We need to have something for our young people, right? And then, of course, I talked about male and female unity, the energy, the maximizing the female energy within us men and maximizing the male and female energy with to bring back Black love. And to make that a thing again. And so there's something for everybody. So now this 100-year plan, May 23rd, 2122, the end game. So where did this date come from? The 100-year plan came from Baba Kaaba. The date, May 23rd, that came from our dear sister, Dr. Susan Tata. Black Matter Lives. It's a collective vibration. It starts with unity, and we're going to see the manifestation. So on May 23rd at 12:12 p.m., we're all going to vibrate. We're going to have a little meditation. We're going to vibrate. And I'm telling you, change is going to come. Okay. And so I'm doing my part. Black Matter Lives. This is all basically the ancestors communicating through us and letting us all know that yes, and as the laws of physics say, for every action there's an equal and opposite reaction. Buffalo. Okay, but there's things we are going to do something to make this change. So Kaaba says 3 out of 100. Unfortunately, that's where we are now, 2022, 3 out of 100. 25 years later, let's get that to 10 out of 100. 50 years from now, let's get it to 25 out of 100. 75 years from now, let's get it up to 50 out of 100. And 2122, we will all be there. So that's kind of the 100-year plan at a high level. I'm going to break that down now, but that's just kind of the high level what we're trying to do. Now, let's talk about the weapons of mass disruption. And again, we're disrupting the epigenetic signal because, you know, 12:12 p.m., May 23rd, 12:12 p.m. So again, the weapons of mass disruption. Okay, Kepra, the spoken word vibrations on becoming. A lot of the work that I've been doing with Rev Shock, the physicist and the metaphysicist, as above, so below, the Gagut equation and Ma'at. That is the process of Kepra, the process of becoming. And again, we need that 3 out of 100 this year, but we're gonna get bigger from there. But the starting of this book and other things that's going on is the start. Whatever time zone, yes, Eastern time, whatever time zone you're in, the May 23rd is the main thing. Unity, this collective transformation, politics, economics, and culture, the Africa, the diaspora, and our collective signal frequency. There's just going to be on May 23rd, there's going to be a mass vibration. It's going to be felt all over the globe. It's the ancestors communicating to us and we're waking up. So that unity, okay, the spoken word vibrations on love and marriage. That's part of it as well. And so that's part of what you get with this webinar, is you get my spoken word on love and marriage. And it has been blessed by the elders and the young people both. So the vibration on the reunification of male and female energy. Okay, that's for the single folks. We got the laws of attraction. The energy and the vibration is going to help you. Okay, and reconnect us. Our relationships are in bad shape as a people. We got to change that. Okay, 3 out of 100 now. 10 out of 100 in 25 years, it's going to happen, people. And then unity, we have to have unity for our young people. Okay, and so that's where rites of passage comes in. Okay, so again, Black Matter Lives is about manifestation. We go through those 7 steps of spiritual growth, and we use meditation to achieve the transformation. So again, you don't get to that 3 out of 100 until you get into that Kepra phase, the Nun, the Ptah, and the Atum. So the way we're going to get from the 3 out of 100 to the, let's just say, the 10 out of 100 in 25 years is the power of meditation, showing gratitude, peace, and acceptance of our current situation. That's going to require meditation, and that's what part of this. That's one of the weapons of mass disruption. So you see on the left, you see my documentary, Sankofa. That's that spoken word documentary. Black Matter Lives, the audiobook. This is what you get with the webinar series. You get the audiobook. It's one thing to read the words in the book, it's another thing to hear my voice and to listen to the chapters, especially the spoken word. The Keys to Life is my meditation series, and then the Primordial Waters of Noon is the spoken word on the As Above, and then you're going to have the spoken word on So Below as well. So these are the weapons of mass disruption. Again, the African rites of passage. You get the program structure and curriculum. You get the curriculum for young people and young adults. Okay, and that's that foundational knowledge and instructional videos. People learn different ways. Some people learn by some short 3-minute clips and then group discussions and all of that. It's different ways in which people learn. So we have leadership discussion worksheets. We got the curriculum for youth. Self-reflection. We have to look back at some of the mistakes that we've made, and we got to grow from some of those. Everybody didn't have the great, everybody didn't have great circumstances growing up. Okay. We have meditations. We have self-reflection worksheets. You can be as a trainer teaching the young people, or some of us need to take this as adults. We need to go back and revisit some of the choices and decisions that we've made. So you see here this learning stage and this working stage and this living stage. There's a facilitation guide for adults and teachers. So this learning stage, parents, beliefs, education, and hobbies. And then you have the peer pressure as we get into those teenage years of sex, drugs, and violence. If we mature into that working stage of life, our choices and circumstances will define our career success, marriage, having children, and the stress of those three alone over a 30 to 40 year working stage in life can take its toll on your health if you don't take good care of your health. Stress, mental health, physical health, all of that. And then if you mature out of the working stage into the living stage and become an elder, we got to focus on money because we're no longer working. Well, how are we doing that for income? If you got to get down with digitalnomics, you got to get down with programs where you can have multiple streams of income coming in. You're no longer working. So what are you doing with your time, the lifestyle, and then your legacy? So those are the things that we focus on. Each of those are modules, part of this curriculum that, again, focuses on some brief reading material, some short video clips to watch and instruct, discussion, self-reflection worksheets, group discussions, and meditations. So all of that, plus the spoken word and all the documentary and Black Matter Lives, all of this are the weapons of mass disruption that are part of this webinar series. They all come with the webinar. Okay, so that those are the key things. And so in addition to all of the, you're going to get a lot of the different, so this is kind of what I talked about, the worksheets, the discussions, and the meditations for all of those. And then again, unfortunately, folks, I mean, I know we want the cliff notes. I know we want to make it happen real quick, but it's going to take time. It's going to take time. 3 out of 100. Now, you know, that may seem like a little amount, but that's a lot when you think of it from the continent and the diaspora. That's enough to really, really make change happen. So this collective vibration on May 23rd at 12:12 p.m., as I say, irregardless of your time zone, that vibration is going to be felt around the world. Okay. And some things are going to happen in order to block. I know I was, I'll talk about that in a minute when we get Ray of Shock back. 10 out of 125 years. This is the curriculum that you're going to be doing. Everybody has a role. You either need to learn this yourself or teach it to the young people. For the next 25 years, we're going to increase this number to 10 out of 100, then 25 out of 100, then 50 out of 100. And then in 100 years, we will be ready. We will be back. Okay. And so that's, again, politics, economics, and culture is the main focus. And so again, Black Matter Lives, it's love is that increases the vibration to disrupt the epigenetic signal. That is, those are the weapons of mass destruction in terms of, and this is the impact that it's going to have. So, you know, Rev Shock, if you, come on back, I'm going to stop sharing, and we're just gonna talk a little bit about you know, the 100-year plan. I know you're talking about you know, Dr. Ray Higgins and basically getting ready, but I remember a lecture by Minister Ava Muhammad in the Nation, and she was talking about using the power of our minds to, you know, if you say, you know, I asked my dad, I was talking to my dad, I said, what can we do to stop? What could have been done to stop that guy in Buffalo? Mm-hmm. What could have been done to stop him? And there's not a lot. He knew that there was a security guard working there.
Who had a gun,
and he did, and the security guard did shoot him, but he knew that was happening, so he wore body armor, you know. And so the bullets just hit the body armor, and but I mean, you know, fortunately he did get stopped before he did other damage. But I remember a long time ago a lecture by Minister Ava Muhammad, who's one of the baddest sisters in the nation. She talked about the power that we have. It was almost like Neo in the Matrix. Once he understood the power that he had, they shot all the bullets and he just put his hand out and the bullet stopped. You know what I mean? Because at some point, when you realize that this is all frequency, okay, once you realize and met the power that you have, then you can stop somebody from even thinking. As soon as they start thinking about doing you harm, you will feel your aura, your frequency, your vibration will feel that negative energy.
Well, how many times have we had situations where maybe we were to travel somewhere, we were supposed to be somewhere, we had been asked or requested to show up somewhere, or we went even to the grocery store, and something just said, nah, don't go. Based upon your frequency and vibration, roadblocks would come up. Something would happen. The situation would get canceled. Another emergency would come up where you weren't going to be there. So there are people who, there are just tons and tons of stories of people who have had this frequency, have had this vibration that protects them. And so in a situation like Boston, in a situation like this shooter, this guy is a situation where there was an axiology that developed that neighborhood, right? So redlining, that's so when we look at epigenetics, we look at historical trauma, we look at his generational poverty and all of this can be explained. All of this is scientific, and all of it has a cause and effect and can be traced. What was the making of that neighborhood for those people to be so vulnerable in what is considered to be a food desert, because there's no other grocery stores around for miles? So what signal can we send where we protect our people, where they'll get a message? Maybe it's not a good day to show up to the supermarket or at this particular time. And we know there are people who have had that message. And didn't show up and didn't get on that airplane, didn't get on that bus, didn't get in that car, didn't go to this event where there was a mass shooting or something happening. This is who we are. Now, it sounds all la-la foo-foo. It sounds miraculous. It sounds esoteric. And the reason is because our signal has been successfully interrupted. And when your original signal in frequency is interrupted, you start to lessen in frequency and lower in vibration. And so all of the negative stuff that's on the soul below starts to affect you, infect you, and move you into a state of shrinking your life and shrinking your existence. We are miracle people. We created the first miracles. We developed the first miracles. We merged the as above with so below and created civilization. As Dr. Winters was speaking early on Sister Shanice's show, he was saying that, listen, man, while the Europeans or the second frequency was devolving in the caves, we were evolving around the world. And when they came out, they were a little pissed off that we kept growing and they didn't keep growing. They actually reverted and reversed in their civility and their ability to be able to create miracles. We were and are and always will be the first and only walking miracles. So what you're teaching us is really how to get back not only to our original frequency, but how do we activate it? How then do we use it? And how do we move in the world now as a living, walking Amma, as a walking god or goddess? This is why I have you on this platform. This is why I love your work. This is why your book has changed so many lives. This is why your webinar is the bomb diggity, because you go in deep. When we talk about this plan, beloved, I would like to see a webinar on the actual plan. So the literal how-to, the as above and so below. The as above is the consciousness aspect, the mindset that you need to have. The so below is the tactical, practical things you need to do, the tools that you need to use, but you have to have the right mind to use the tools. We've got the tools, but if it's not the right mind, then the tools don't work. Is that correct?
Absolutely. I mean, there's a saying, give a fool a tool, he's still a fool. You know?
I haven't heard that one. I like that. I like that. I'm going to use that.
You got to get the mind right. And the book, you know, and I see a comment, Evolving Thoughts. Is all that in the book? The book is literally just the foundation. The weapons are more in the webinar because it goes deep into the spoken word. You can't feel the vibration from the spoken word by reading the words in the book. That's reading true. The words Absolutely. In the book are powerful.
Right.
Reading
right.
the words in the book is powerful. I mean, we all have read books, have gotten, you know, a couple of nuggets and have gotten good, great information. But the vibration comes through the spoken word. And that's why mm-hmm. you get that with the webinar, with the audio book, with all of my spoken word. All the poetry is in the book. Mm-hmm. And poetry mm-hmm. is powerful. Okay. But hearing me recite the poetry, that's where the vibration comes. And what Rev Shock is saying is that although it might be 3 out of 100 in 2022, that 3 out of 100 with the collective vibration, can that energy and signal can be felt by those on top of buildings thinking about jumping off. And you just get you hear a sense of, brother, sister, I see you. And then you decide not to jump.
That's
or
correct.
Someone who wants to come and harm our people, the 97 out of 100, we can send a message to that security guard that says, bro, look out for this fool. Okay,
mm-hmm.
And send a signal to that 18-year-old. 18, that's too young. Let's say, look, mm-hmm. fool, we see you, bro. Don't come here.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
Once we put aside these differences and we have that unity where we care and love about everybody, all of our
mm-hmm.
people,
mm-hmm.
unconditional, unapologetic love for everyone Black, foundational Black people.
Mm-hmm.
That starts.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
That's the start. And then the manifestation is using our power and unity to manifest change. And we understand mm-hmm. our original first frequency, and we use the power of that frequency mm-hmm. to affect change.
Yeah, and let me make a note.
But
yeah, let me make a note to the family members who a lot of us have been conditioned to just buy the next book. And if we buy the next book and watch a couple of YouTube videos, we're gonna be all right. And that's problematic, right? Because a book is not going to save your life, it's simply going to inform you. And you need something experiential. So there you need to take a deep dive. You read the book, you might have questions. Where do you go to get an answer? We all learn from experiential learning. And in the digital space, that's obviously through either live or pre-recorded videos, because on a video, there's things you can transfer and transmit that I'm sorry, you cannot get in a book, because the four-part webinar series you did, none of that stuff was in the book. I mean, it was in the book in terms of an outline, but you went deep, deep, deep.
Life.
And yeah, that stuff was like, oh, snap. And I read the same book, but I didn't get, I got a lot more when I was on the webinar. So there's a reason why this is a 3 out of 100. We know that everybody is not going, we know some people don't have the money. to pay for these products and services to go a step further. We're happy that you buy books and watch YouTube videos and hope that you'll get to a certain point. But at some point, you're going to be following the lead of the people, one, that are producing the work and teaching. And also, you're going to be following the people who are doing the research that is pushing the needle forward so that we have a strategy and a plan in place once the AMU has been diminished because of AMA's great wish of reducing their numbers and putting them into a birth dearth. Once that happens, what are we going to do and how are we going to be ready and prepared? Because if we're not ready and prepared, all we're going to do is take the trauma of white male patriarchy that has traumatized us since the beginning, and we're just going to repeat what they have done. And you can't get that from a book or from just watching a YouTube video. I'm sorry. And the reason I say this is because I tried. I tried. I bought a man in the beginning. That's really your beginning stage, is buying up a bunch of books, learning your history, understanding all of this stuff. But then it wasn't until I started, my process was I started interviewing a lot of these people, now over 2,035 years. And I got a deeper understanding because guess what? Yeah, there's the book, but if I can talk to the author, I could ask questions that would elucidate an entirely new idea or concept from that one sentence, paragraph, or chapter. So now what we got to do is we've got to get a series, and which is what we're doing, a series of high-end teachers and people who are qualified to teach this, such as a Ron Spears, to come into the classroom, to come into your home and do some one-on-one coaching with you, if you will, which is really kind of what the webinar series is about. The fact that there were people on there and Ron at the end when we did the Q&A was able to answer every single question, even questions that wasn't related to the damn webinar, but it was related to their life. So it was related in that sense. So this is why this is important. And I don't expect everybody to go. This is a special group, and we're looking for a special mindset of people. That 3 out of 100 is a hell of a group, and we understand that it is our job to lead the masses in this research, in this process, because everybody is not capable of going at this particular time. They can only play a certain part and certain role, and if that's just watching the YouTube video and reading a book, fine. But somebody else has to come along with deeper knowledge to give you the ability to activate what's in that book or what you've read to help you with your comprehension and understanding. Something that I talk about and I'm getting ready to teach on a deeper level, the trauma that is in our bodies, the four traumas that have plagued our bodies and plaqued our ability to move ourselves forward. I have seen systematically it lowers our emotional intelligence. It creates, somebody put it up in the chapter, in the chat earlier, it creates an arrested development in us. That arrested development lowers our emotional intelligence. When our emotional intelligence is lowered, we can read a bunch of books, but we're not going to have the comprehension to be able to unlock what's in that book. And it's just going to be another piece of intellectual property that you say, oh yeah, I know Ron Spears. Oh yeah, I got that book, and you're excited about it, but ain't shit changed in your life because of all the trauma and the drama that you can't see. It's like Dr. AJ Varma was on here a couple of weeks ago, and he said, you can't self-diagnose yourself, right? I can't self-diagnose myself. So I have to talk to all of these great scholars to be able to bring back what I deal with the trauma that's inside of me, remove the trauma that's inside of me, so I can see clear, right? You can't see clear if that signal is interrupted by trauma, and that's what I think is the differentiating factor between just reading a book and becoming a part and joining a webinar and taking a deeper dive, going into class, going back to university, going to school, upgrading your upgrade, bettering your best. Ron, what is your experience in this?
Yeah, no, that's I'm glad you mentioned that, Rev Shock, because people need to understand Ron Spears and Rev Shock didn't just pop out 2 years ago. No. Okay. You're looking at over 50 years of experiential learning. Okay. Right. And it is the books are not what made us who we are. It was the life experiences, which is the application of the foundational knowledge. Okay. Right. I studied physics over 30 years ago, right? That's when I took my first quantum mechanics class, or and that special relativity class in that fourth dimension. That was over 30 years ago. Mm-hmm. I've been taking kids to Africa. I've been doing rites of passage programs since the 90s, mm-hmm. right? And mm-hmm. doing a lot of things, writing the poetry, all of that didn't just happen in the past 6 months.
Right. This is
life experiences. Right. Okay, 26 or some odd years of marriage. You do the math, 1996. Right. 26 years of marriage taught me a lot. Okay.
No doubt.
And raising two kids who are now adults has taught me a lot, has humbled me and taught me a lot. And then reading a lot of great books, and that's going to be one of the webinars. Man, I'm going to take mm-hmm. you to my library. This is a prop. My mm-hmm. library is up there. When you see my Goggle shelf, you see my Egyptian shelf, when you see my physics shelf, I mean, you know, that'll be a webinar within itself.
And that's a good point that you bring up, because Dr. Clyde Winters, I think he has over, he had 7,000 books. I think he had a flood or something. So now he's down about three or 4,000. Woo-hoo. I've got about 1,000, I think it's 1,100 Kindles in my Kindle, in my digital. And then my physical books is in the living room and everywhere else. My queen, when we first got together, and she came to my, I was living in an apartment in Chicago, and she came to the apartment. And she went in the kitchen and she opened up the cabinets. She was, getting ready to try to make me something to eat or whatever. And in the cabinets, in the kitchen cabinets, was books. I mean, it was, she said, I'm in love with this man because he's a brilliant mind, because he's got books in the damn kitchen shelves. I mean, so it's so many books. But here's the thing, fam, that's over a period of time. But the difference is we got a lot of people that have a lot of books. Exactly. But how do you apply the information? If you just have the book and you read it based upon your trauma, that book is stored as entertainment, not as activated education.
Right. Right.
I want y'all to get that now. That book, all those books you've read, if you're in the same, if you've been reading these types of books for the last 30, 40 years, and you're still in the same situation that you're in, you're still financially struggling, you're still dealing with relationship issues or whatever the level of manifestation is, that should give you the impetus to understand reading the book ain't enough.
Right.
It's the foundation of the discipline to get the books in the discipline, but you got to activate this stuff, man. You got to live this. It's got to become one with the only one. Go ahead, Ron.
Yeah, so kind of the breakdown of the 100-year plan, because I was going to go sort of within the Keys to Life modules of the curriculum that's part of the webinar. First is parents. If you think about that learning stage, parents, mm-hmm. system, education, and hobbies, and then the teenage years, the peer pressure, sex, drugs, and violence. So let's start with parents, okay? Every Black family unit has to be based on love and compassion, okay?
Uh-oh. We know that. Did we lose you there? Okay, there we go.
Oh, okay. We're good?
Mm-hmm.
Every Black family has
to be based. Yeah, you close for a moment. Go ahead.
Okay, sorry about that. Family unit, the Black family unit has to be based on love and compassion. That's what every child growing up mm-hmm. needs to feel, that energy and love and compassion from their parents. We know that we're not there yet for all of our families. We mm-hmm. know we're not mm-hmm. there yet, but that those values and everything needs to happen. That's why There's meditation. That's why in the next 25 years, we need to start moving back in that direction. So instead of 3 out of 100, let's get to 10 out of 100 in 25 years, 25 out of 100. We've got to build that Black family back, and that's the parents. We become better parents. So that's part of that energy, that vibration. Now, belief system, again, it's B1. The churches, mosques, the organizations, fraternities, sororities, no more shade, just love, okay? Unconditional love. You need to do, so here's an example. My church adopted a village in West Africa 30 years ago. We've been supporting them. Clean water system, a $60,000 clean water system. Okay. And I'm just, we're about to send money for 15 scholarships so that they can go to trade school, all that. And we're opening a market. We're about to dedicate a women's marketplace in next month when I travel there. Okay. And we're giving them some wholesale stuff that they can sell retail in the, from their village, from this marketplace. We're empowering women to be business owners in this village. Right. So, I mean, just, we adopted this village over 30 years ago. So here's one thing. Every church, every mosque, every organization, every fraternity, every sorority, adopt a village in Africa. You know, the diaspora that's in need. Adopt and just support them. Love on them. We have such great resources so that they're not dependent on China infrastructure. We have the brilliance and expertise to do that. That's why we did the water system there instead of somebody else. So that's the belief system. B1, foundational, first frequency, understand African sacred science, unity. So beliefs, education. I mean, we can't diss schools. We need these HBCUs, free tuition at these HBCUs. They are putting out Black excellence, right? And you know, there's a lot of schools that's teaching some craziness. We understand that, okay? But some of these schools are definitely putting out Black excellence. And if you look at some of these things from an education standpoint, right now, Harvard, $100 million that they just said, announcing their role in how slavery enslaved Africans, Americans, helped them to grow their endowment and their organization. Other schools, Georgetown, Brown University, have all acknowledged their role. And so free tuition for HBCUs and these Ivy League schools.
Well, basically, it should be free tuition for any foundational African, period. You know, forget what you heard. It should be free for everyone. But here's the problem. If the institution is owned and operated and held accountable by second frequency, as Dr. Winters teaches us, some of us need to become our own PhDs outside of the school or the academic system in America. I don't want the family members who didn't get the proper education, didn't get the proper quote unquote credential, to feel like they're going to be left behind and left out. That is one of the reasons why we're doing webinars and with scholars and doctors and we're teaching how to do research and how to apply these things at the PhD level from PhDs who are foundational Black Americans. Now, also, we got coming back to the platform is next week, Dr. Marie Charles, who does foundational Black British work and in anthropology, archaeology, linguistics, Africana phenomenology, so on and so forth. And we need to sit at the feet of these people and take their webinars, take their teachings and trainings so that we can compete. If we're not able, if we ran out of some level of time or ran out of money or what, or both, we still need to be able to compete with those that are coming out of college to be able to understand what's going on as a result. So this is for the people, and this is a new Kemet. This is a new Kemet that's being built here. You have to understand, family, when you go, depending upon your neighborhood and where you live, you can drive a few blocks, perhaps a few miles, and what you're going to see when we see poverty, what you're really seeing is you're seeing a war zone. You're seeing the aftermath. We've seen photos of natural disasters, like, well, it wasn't natural because it was the white male patriarchy did it, but we see Chernobyl, or we'll see what happens when we drop, you know, bombs on communities, and we see all of those buildings that are just dilapidated, and well, that's what's happened to us on this continent. That's what Dr. Claude Anderson refers to as a hood. A hood is nothing more than a bomb that has gone off. We're living in bomb shelters. We're living in the aftermath of a war that is still going on. You're in a war zone. So you call it your house, you call it your neighborhood, you call it the block, whatever you want to call it, it's war. And it's an act of war on you. And you and me have to learn how to reverse engineer what has happened to us so that we can manage and handle what is happening to us, because it hasn't stopped. It's just changed form. But we're living in a bomb shelter every single day. And in order to get out, we have to reverse engineer. We have to have our best thinkers. And I want the community to understand we're bringing. So I'm sure this is going to catch on. I hope it does. We're going to make Kemet great again. we're truly going to make America great again, because we're going to make Kemet great again in America and around the world in the diaspora. So that's our that's our goal. That's our agenda. Yeah, I say that's our goal and agenda. And for me, I had to look at what's missing in the bandwidth of scholarship within Afrocentricity, Africana phenomenology, and within the scholars of quote unquote the Hotep community. What's missing and what's not being done? What's missing is a cohesion of all of the sciences, all of the disciplines, all of the scholarships coming together under one framework and foundation. The other thing that's missing is activation, how to, right? Because we need a great deal of information to find out, well, okay, here's what's happened to us. Here's the lies. Here's how we dispel the lies, all of these things. So now we've got this foundation of information. But how do we take that information and turn it into transformation, where it transforms us individually first, then to our family, from our family, then to the community? That's the way that everything works. It's the way that trauma works. When we are traumatized, it's we individually are first traumatized. If that trauma is not metabolized properly or recognized and eliminated, then that trauma becomes our dominant personality. Then that dominant personality engages with the family, creating new trauma imprints in the family. And now it's a trauma dance within the family. That family goes out in the world, and now it becomes culture. We've got to work on us individually. We've got to make Kemet great again inside of us. We've got to make America great inside of us. We've got to learn what it means to be foundational Black Americans. We've got to learn what it means to be first frequency individually. And stop all of this nonsense about what we going to do, when we going to get together. We ain't going to get together until we get our individual selves together. Right? So F what you heard, it ain't going to happen until you get your shit together. So where do you go to do that, right? So where do you go to get the knowledge, the information, and the framework? That's what we're doing here. Go ahead, beloved.
Absolutely, yeah. And it's good. I have to kind of keep reminding the family what I'm sharing right now is a 100-year plan, but not just a 100-year plan without just in general. This is a 100-year plan based on a collective vibration from Black mm-hmm. Matter Lives. Okay, so Black Matter Lives is the start. It's the spark. Right. It is the So this is just a 100 years of manifestation. So we're not talking about going to Harvard or going to University of Michigan, which is just with your current mind. No, this is with a new mindset, right? Yeah. And so when I'm talking about education, I'm talking about from a Black Matter Lives foundation. So you're taking that to these institutions.
That's okay. Right. And so what somebody said, Madam Mojo says, and we still need plumbers. Absolutely. We need people who know trade. My father was a plumber. He was probably one of the greatest mathematicians I've ever met, because plumbing at that level that he was operating, you got to know math. And so these, we're not talking, just because you're in a trade doesn't mean that you're not educated and not capable of education and comprehension. In Kemet, everybody knew the same thing, but everybody had different roles, but everybody had the same mindset. And you understand what I'm saying? That's what Dr. Marie Charles meant when she says there was only one culture. There was not there was no descent. There was no other cultures. It was one culture. Now, in that culture, you might have been a person that dealt with iron. Somebody else might have dealt with copper. Somebody else might have dealt with education. Somebody else might have dealt with sewage. Somebody else might have dealt with electricity or whatever it was, whatever the necessity was. We had those people, but they were all of the same consciousness.
Yep. Yep. Because
everybody has a gift. So the plumber is necessary. Trust me, because I don't know. I didn't like having to take all those when I was working with my pops. I didn't like having to take all those pipes and run them up four flights of steps for them. So we need some plumbers out here because I'm not doing it. But we need to run electrical in the house. I'm not doing it. I need somebody to be able to fix my car, because I open that damn thing up, I have no idea what I'm looking at. There used to be a time when we could fix our own cars and change our own oils. Not no more. So it doesn't matter what your profession is, it matters what your consciousness is.
Absolutely. And so kind of moving down to hobbies, we have we're starting to see a surgence of Black athletes. I mean, the gymnasts are now all Black, golfers and other things.
Yeah, wasn't it amazing? Look, Tiger Woods, right? I mean, this guy is third frequency crazy.
Started on the tour.
Is that right? He's a brother?
They showed him on Mother's Day hugging his mother.
What?
21-year-old brother.
There it is. There it is. You only need that one, and then it becomes, you know, a domino effect. But understand,
the Black Matter,
this ain't nothing new. Everything we do and everything we touch, we're going to do it as first frequency. We just don't know we're first frequency.
So here's the Black Matter Lives version of the 100-year plan. Right now, 3 out of 100. So say Deion Sanders, Eddie George, and the other brother who's, you know, Jackson State, that's getting the athletes to come to the HBCUs, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, now Jackson State games are on ESPN. So TV contract revenue that's going to be coming. So if there's a surge of others, now we got 3 out of 100, but now let's get more. And so now if the athletes start coming, our star athletes come to HBCUs and the TV contracts come back home, just think what can happen now. Now these schools can better afford their knowledge and upgrade their facilities, upgrade their dorms, upgrade their learning materials. They can get scholars to come there and teach the real deal, right? So that's sort of that aspect of it. And we can have a pipeline to basically put them towards their profession so that they're not dependent on this Division I money and this Division I energy that can really, really mess their heads up or has messed their heads up. So let's come back home. Right. And that's all that's necessary. And I hear you, Brian Beno. Greg Carr, man, that brother's got books. That brother has books. And you see the pictures of John Henry Clark in his library and Leonard Jeffries. Anyway, back on task. Y'all got me running off. Hobbies. So now let's get the peer pressure. That's where the teenage years. That's where the rites of passage programs need to come. Okay. We need to have these rites of passage programs so that these kids can have that knowledge of self so they can focus on that. Right now, let's go one step further. When they graduate from rites of passage into that teenage years, let's get them a life insurance policy.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
okay.
Mm-hmm.
As a graduation present. It's real cheap when you're that young. Folks ain't gonna be killing young people anymore with it when you got millions of dollars. I mean, it's just a different level of thinking in the black space, right?
Absolutely.
So now that's getting out of that learning stage of life because you have a new mindset now, and you've been radicalized is not the right word. You've been conscious now because this is Black Matter Lives.
Well, that's how they're going to couch it. That anything that's Black identity is a radical thinking. So that it won't be long until we become the Black identity, critical race theory. All of that will become will move into the terrorism category, and will become a domestic terrorist because of our ideology of wanting to live in our original first frequency foundational Black American state. That's just the way it is and what's going to happen. And we're ready for it. And we've got a plan in place for that as well. But this is what we're up against, my beloved. Go ahead.
Absolutely. So now we're in that working stage of life. And so, yes, it is a focus on trades, careers, all of that. If you're working within your purpose, working within your gift, and you're working for the development, but you know, you got to have that business owner mindset and mentality. Mm-hmm. I love what the sister Pinky Cole did at Clark Atlanta University's commencement last weekend. She gave all the graduates a LLC. So now they're all business owners, right? Mm-hmm. It's just getting the right, the mindset of being entrepreneurs. Okay. And so I'm part of an accelerator. I just got trained to be part of, because, you know, I'm big on STEM, obviously physicist. So I'm big on STEM and engineering, science, technology, engineering, and math. And I'm really into STEAM because I'm a spoken word artist. So STEAM is science, technology, engineering, the arts, and math. Understanding nature and breaking down nature, make Kemet great again, MKGA. I saw that, the hat. They understood the hieroglyphics are not words, it's drawings, it's art, okay, nature. So anyway, I'm part of this accelerator now to kind of build more entrepreneurs. So you take these folks getting engineering and PhDs in engineering, and we're turning them into entrepreneurs, start focusing on the HBCUs. So, I mean, it's just something that we need to focus on. Now, career and then marriage. We talk about Black love, the spoken word. Well, it's part of the webinar. It's part of Black Matter Lives, male and female energy. We need to have more relationships built on trust, respect, and planning. Okay, personal goals, family goals, couple goals. We need to build our relationships so that we can have children. And then it goes into that cycle of parents. What do these children need? They need security. They need love and compassion from the family unit. And so now you have that planning. And so you're going to be planning to have children, and you're going to raise them in an environment that is nurturing and building on that love and compassion. That's the 5, the 10, the 25, the 50, the 75, the 100 year plan for Black Matter Lives, changing that mindset, doing the meditations to kind of help heal the wounds and disrupt the signal, okay, that has really affected us, the 4 traumas that's still affecting you now. The meditation and the vibration is what can disrupt that signal.
Absolutely.
Disruption. That is what it's going to take time, though. And that's the reality.
That's why, as a plan, this is an intergenerational plan. And I think one of the things that happens to us is that because of the oppression of suppression, and subsequently depression of colonialism on us when we're born into this incarnation, where whatever time we're born into, we think that we want everything in our life, and we end up cutting ourselves and shooting ourselves in the foot, because part of our issue and situation is that we're not thinking generationally. We're just thinking about our own lives right now. And when you do that, this is what society in the African-American community looks like, a foundational Black American community looks like. It looks like everybody is every man for himself. you don't understand that this is a plan. It's a journey. What's that sport in the Olympics, Ron, where they run and they pass the baton to each
relay
other?
Relay race or track and
field. Relay race. Relay. This is a relay race, man. This is a relay. And so what's your baton? Do you have a baton? Your baton is your knowledge, your applied knowledge and wisdom. It's your transformation. But if you keep running, like most of us are just on a treadmill running to stand still with that baton, you ain't passing nothing on, right? You got to get off the damn treadmill of second frequency, third frequency, and fourth frequency. Get off of that, get on your first frequency vehicle and go straight to the top so you can pass that baton on, that knowledge, information, and transformation on to the next generation. And so that requires us to be a little bit selfish and selfless. In order to give something, you have to have something. So you've got to be selfish in what it takes to get the knowledge, to understand how to apply the knowledge, to be able to soldier up, if you will, within your own space and zip code. And then from there, pass that on and activate this knowledge and move the generation forward. Go ahead.
Yeah, and that's a plug for webinar number one on Gagoop, because the comma is the transformation, right? In order to make that transformation, you've got to deal with the God force within and the negative, the counter force, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Everybody has that Judas. Everybody has that devil on the shoulder. Everybody has that. You can't make that transformation once you make that transformation, that's elevate your consciousness into that next level, the noon patah atum, you're going to be stuck canceling each other out. Mm-hmm. And so that's the Gagoop equation right there. Because once you make that transformation, now you can manifest your life unopposed, to no longer hindered by that negative force that's keeping you back. So that's the plug for that first webinar on Gagoop, when I break Gagoop down. And so now webinar 2, 3, and 4 is now that you're able to manifest, you're able to make things happen.
But absolutely.
Happen until, I mean, you can do a lot of things and think that you're doing things, but then it's like one step forward, two steps back.
Well, it's what Zig Ziglar used to refer to as a wandering generality versus a meaningful specific. Most of those wandering generalities, we just bounce from one YouTube video to another, buy one book from another, and we think we woke and making progress, and we ain't doing shit. And so we got to become a meaningful specific. This is what meaningful first frequency B1 foundational Black Africans found Americans foundational Black British. That's activation. That's meaningful specific. So go ahead, beloved. I got to get ready and get out of here too. So I just want to let the family know we're getting ready to close it down. But this has been absolutely amazing, as always, with you, my beloved.
Closing out that working stage is the health aspect. So that's where we need to start really focusing on our health and taking good care of ourselves. Once we get that signal disrupted and we start eating foods and exercise and doing the things that's going to, for mentally, physically, spiritually, all of that. And so now that living stage where you're talking about, when we become elders, yes, we are saving money. We are making money well into our elder years. Okay. Because we're giving back, we're working in our purpose. We're doing things with our time and all of that. And that's that, what you say, that legacy, the relay race. You're right. Bino, it's a marathon, not a sprint. You have that baton to leap. That's the legacy that you're leaving behind. So that's that living stage. So that's all part of the curriculum. That's part of the webinar series. You get the curriculum and it breaks all of that down. And so that's where it really gives you all the tools, all the weapons that you need to make lasting change in this society for the next 100 years, because that's what's going to help us to get there. So, you know, that's the focus. My next webinar series is going to just break down a lot of that right now. Get this webinar, start using this curriculum, putting the feedback in. And then once you guys all have that feedback, we're going to break down each one of these areas a lot deeper, as above, so below.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to just take it to that next level and start manifesting this 100-year plan. And that's going to be the focus. So that's all I wanted to cover today, Rev Shock. But, you know, I'm going to be kind of taking a little bit of a break because I'm going to Kemet. And so mm-hmm. I'm gonna have a whole lot. We're already working on another documentary and another aspect of, because that Gagut really got me going. That next level tensor, and drawing that parallel with the Dogon and the twinness of the Dogon. That caught me. I wasn't expecting that. So I'm gonna explore that a little bit deeper. You got to wait for the next webinar series. But I'm gonna be in Kemet, so I'll be back on your show in a month.
Okay.
Of going to Kemet, and then in June I'm going to be going to West Africa to take the whole Eagle Scouts through the rites of passage ritual, so in the Gambia, and I'm going to report out on all the projects that we're doing there. So I'm gonna talk about that, and then this next webinar will probably start in that July time frame. So I'm gonna be busy, fam, but I'll keep you up to date on all that's going on. But this is the 100-year plan. Black Matter Lives. It's not just a book, it's a movement. Unity.
Fantastic.
And station for the next 100 years.
Fantastic, beloved. I appreciate you, and I'm looking forward to it. Have safe travels and safe journey. Can't wait for you to come back and stay in the black, baby. All right, family. We'll see you next time on First Frequency of Oneness.